Welcome back, my students. I am your SST teacher, Vandana Joshi, and you are watching SST June. So, students, hope you all are well in your health and doing studies in your home. So, students, today I am back with a new chapter in geography, that is natural vegetation and wildlife. So, students, in this chapter, we will study about many topics like the forest, the wildlife in the forest, and the different type of vegetation in the different areas. So students, before going to start our new chapter, let's have a look upon a story which has been given in your book. So students, it's a story of Salima, and she was very excited about the summer camp which she was attending. She had gone to visit Manali in Himachal Pradesh along with her classmates. She recalled how surprised she was to see the change in the landform and natural vegetation as the bus climbed higher and higher. Most probably, students, you have also seen these type of differences near around your areas. And if you will compare between the areas where you are living, and if you will compare the other places' areas, the landforms and the vegetations are totally different. So, as Salima was also looking over there. So, the deep jungles of the foothill comprising sal and teak slowly disappeared. She could see tall trees with thin pointed leaves and cone-shaped canopies on the mountain slopes. I think, students, you are also recalling that trees of pine wood and different type of conical shape trees in the mountain areas. So, as Salima also learnt that those were coniferous trees. She noticed blooms of bright flower on tall trees. These were the rhododendrons. From Manali, as she was traveling up to Rohtang Pass, she saw that the land was covered with short grass and snow in some places. So students, while you were listening to the story of Salima's, you also might be recalling the different type of trees and the vegetation, the flowers and the wildlife as well, students, near around your areas, or must be when you have traveled in a very interior area or the hill stations, you have also seen these type of vegetation. Students, I hope you have listened one word there, that is coniferous forest. So what are the coniferous forest? And first of all, what is forest and what is natural vegetation? So, to know more about these topics, let's start our new chapter, that is natural vegetation and wildlife. So, students, first of all, we will look upon intro of the chapter and which topic we will cover in this chapter. So, let's start. So, students, as you can see on the board, we will study these topics in our this chapter. So what are the topics? So first of all, we will see the introduction of the chapter, in which we will see what is natural vegetation and what is the meaning of wildlife. And students, this chapter is containing two major topics. These are forest and the second is grassland. So in our today's video, we will study the first topic, that is forest. In this topic, students, we will cover these six subtopics. These are the tropical evergreen forest, second, tropical deciduous forest, third, the temperate evergreen forest, fourth, temperate deciduous forest, fifth, Mediterranean vegetation, and the sixth is coniferous forest, about which Salima was talking. Okay, so students, let's start our new chapter with its introduction. So students, first see what is the natural vegetation and the wildlife. So if we will talk about the natural vegetation, the vegetation which can be grow by itself without any human effort, that is known as natural vegetation. As you can see in this board, the natural vegetation. It refers to all kind and species of plants life that grow on their own without the intervention of humans. So students, as you can see, there is no interference of any human beings, and the natural vegetation can be grow by itself. And if we talk about the wildlife, as all you know, the wildlife and the faunas which we are getting inside the forest, the wild animals and these type of animals and birds, insects, these all are including in the wildlife of the natural vegetation. So students, the growth of vegetation, it depends upon several factors like temperature, rainfall, sunlight, soil texture, height above the sea level, and different type of factors through which we can divide the natural vegetation as well. Okay, so students, since these factors, the factors which I told you, that height upon the sea levels, that sunlight and the soil, different type of factors, the factors, they vary from place to place. It can't be same from one place to another place. If you will compare even the landforms are different, plateau landforms, plain landforms, the mountain landforms. So that's why the variation between the vegetation is also there. So students, if you want to categorize the natural vegetation, the natural vegetation can be categorized into four major parts. The first is forest, which we are going to start. Second is the grassland. Third is desert vegetation, and the fourth is the tundras vegetation. So students, first of all, we will see what is forest and what are the different types of forest. So students, what are the forest? Forest kya hote hain? The forest are thick cover of trees which grow where the condition necessary for the natural vegetation. So students, if we talk about the different areas, the forest are which we are getting, these are in different species in the different areas. So students, if we want to be categorize the forest, we can be categorize the forest into two major parts. So first of all, that is evergreen, and the second category is the deciduous forest. And if we will categorize the forest into zone areas, means in the different zones of the world, the forest can be categorized into again two parts. First is the tropical and the second is temperate. More are there, like your coniferous forest and the Mediterranean forest. But the major parts are for the evergreen and the deciduous, these are the tropical and the temperate. So students, let's see what are the tropical forest and what are the temperate forest, and how these are divided into evergreen and the deciduous. So let's start. So students, first of all, we will talk about the tropical evergreen forest. The tropical evergreen forest are found in equatorial and wet tropical region. Here, temperature is hot and humid throughout the year, and the annual rainfall is between 1800 and 2500 millimeter. So, these forests are also known as tropical rainforest. There is no particular dry season, so the trees do not shed their leaves altogether. So that is the significance of the tropical evergreen forest, students, that these trees are not, they do not shed their leaves. In these forests, the trees are tall with hardwood and broad leaves that form a thick canopy at the top. These forests found in the Amazon and Orinoco River basin and South America, the Jeira Basin in Africa, and the Southeast Asian countries of Indonesia, Malaysia, and in the northeastern parts of India. Students, the rosewood, ebony, mahogany are the common trees in these tropical evergreen forest. And if we talk about the wildlife in these type of forest, a wide variety of wildlife is found in these thick forest, such as monkeys, apes, sloths, pumps, jaguars, hippopotamus, crocodiles, alligators, turtles, and different types of birds and the insects. Students, the animals living in the tropical forest are adapted to live among trees. A rich variety of birds such as parrots and toucans are also inhabited in this type of forest. So students, if we talk about the tropical deciduous forest, these are also known as the monsoon forest. They experience monsoons type of climate. The rainfall in these forest is less. It is around 100 to 200 centimeter than the evergreen forest. But the temperature remain high. Trees are of medium height and shade their leaves in the dry season in order to conserve water. So students, this is also a significance of the tropical deciduous forest, that these trees are shedding their leaves during the dry season to conserve the water. So students, there is a dense undergrowth of bushes and shrubs. The trees of these forests are commercially very valuable and are used for making furniture and for transport and construction material. The teak, sal, sandalwood, shisham, bamboo, and eucalyptus are the major or you can say the important trees in these areas. These type of forests are found in the western ghats of South India, Shivalik Hills of North India, Central America, and Northern Australia. And students, if you talk about the wildlife of that tropical deciduous forest, these forests are the breeding ground of tigers, lions, elephants, leopards, bears, rhinoceros, langurs, monkeys, deers, and snakes. Especially the snakes like deadly cobra and vipers. Now let's move to the next type of forest, that is temperate evergreen forest. These forests are found in the region where winters are mild and rainfall is abundant throughout the year. These are found in the continents in middle latitude. These are mixed forest with both broadleaf and the needle leaves trees and both hardwood and softwood trees. The main species are oak, pine, and camphor, mulberry, eucalyptus, etc. These trees have good commercial value and are commonly found in southeastern USA, southern China, and southeastern Brazil, and also in eastern coast of South Africa and Australia. Students, if we talk about the wildlife in the temperate evergreen forest, the wildlife is the giant pandas, deer, antelopes, monkeys, bears, wolves, fox, and a large variety of birds like falcons, eagles, pelicans, and many more are there, which we can see in the temperate evergreen forest. Let's see what are the temperate deciduous forest. These forests are found in area with warm, wet summer and cool, frosty winters. Rainfall has throughout the year, with the maximum rainfall in summer. The trees are tall, having broad leaves with a dense canopy in summer. In winter, they shade their leaves completely. The leaves of these trees change into bright color just before they shade. Their common species are oak, ash, beech, maple, poplar, redwood, birch, and elm. They are found in northeastern part of USA, China, New Zealand, southern China, and coastal region of Western Europe. Students, if we talk about the wildlife of the temperate deciduous forest, it consists different type of deers, foxes, wolves, and bisons, and bears, and wild cats. Birds like monas, warblers, and peewees, red-eye, vireos, and many more are there. These are the world of the temperate deciduous forest. Now, next type of the forest is the Mediterranean forest. So, why we are saying the Mediterranean forest, students? Because these forests are generally found in areas which are on the southwestern margins of continents Australia and South America. And the trees of these regions adapt themselves very well to dry summers with the help of their thick barks, deep roots, and wax-coated narrow leaves, which help them to reduce transpiration. And students, if we talk about the commonly found trees, these are cork, oak, live oak, pine, olive, mahogany, fig, and many citrus fruits like orange, lemon, olive, and grapes. And students, if we talk about the wildlife in the Mediterranean areas, the commonly found there the fox and the deers. And if we talk about the birds, these are many type of Californian quills and sugar birds, black, terotid, divers, and many type of snakes are also there, like grass snakes and slow worms, and some reptiles are also found in these type of forest. And at the last, the coniferous forest. Students, these forests are found in region where long winters and usually high annual precipitation. They consist mainly of evergreen cone bearing trees with needle shaped leaves and softwood timber. They are also found in the higher altitude on high mountain ranges like Himalayas and the Alps. Student, Alps is also a mountain range. Students, the trees are extremely commercial value because they are used for making pulp, which is used for manufacturing papers and new prints. And students, if we talk about the types of the species found in these forests are cheer, pine, cedar, fir, spruce, and the lark. The main areas rich of these forests are southern Canada, Russia, Norway, northern part of America, Europe, Asia, and Sweden. And the wildlife. What is the wildlife in the coniferous forest areas? So students, the animals, those are living in the coniferous forest areas, the animals, they have the thick skin or fur to protect them from the extreme cold. They are small in size, like silver fox, mink, polar bear, walrus, seals, wolves, musk oxen, and raccoon, squirrel, and the reindeers. And the birds include the woodpeckers, crossbills, warblers, hawks, and the owls. So students, during the winter season, most of these animals and birds migrate to warm areas in search of food. So students, Hope you have seen the different type of forest and understood the matter about the forest which I have explained to you. So students, in our next video, we will see more about the natural vegetation, in which we will study about the natural vegetation. So for that, keep watching SST June.